Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how to build a release pipeline to deploy a static website inside the Azure Blob Storage. Si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de cette vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. So in the previous video, I show you how to create the build pipeline. So now our artifacts are published and ready to be used. Now what we want is to create a release pipeline. And in that release pipeline, we'll be creating the Azure resources and moving our files to our blob storage. The best way to create resources in a CI/CD is to use ARM templates. So let's do this. So I'm now back in Visual Studio Code and I will add a new JSON file to write my ARM template. So in the deployment folder, I will create a new file and we'll name it deploy.json. Because I'm using the extension of Visual Studio Code, it's very easy for me to create a new ARM template. So let's first create an empty skeleton and we'll add a new resource. So what I need is the Azure storage. So it's STG, so we'll do this. And let's rename it Blob Storage. Now there's a little bug right now in the snippet. This comma here doesn't need to be there. In fact, need to be the line just above it. So now it would be better to use parameter. So let's add a parameter. And I will use the type as a string. And I will put the default value as William Frank Demo. Great. So now instead of using parameter name here, I will be using this. I will just put lowercase. So blob storage is the name of my variable. And now here I need to use it. So I will use the square brackets and I will use parameter exactly. And then blob storage. Now that we have our ARM template, we also want that deployment accessible to our release pipeline. So we need to add one more step in the Azure pipeline before publishing the artifact. What we want is to also copy the content. Well, let's scroll it up. So what we want is also to have the ARM template accessible. So we need to copy the file in the deployment folder to subfolder deployment also. And then we'll copy that. So now, let's commit all of it. We'll trigger a new build and then we'll be starting working on our release pipeline. Perfect, so the build was successful. So now we're ready to create our release. So let's go here, new pipeline. And now we'll start with an empty one and we'll pick our artifact. So click here, it's perfect from the build. And then I will pick my project. Latest version, and I will just name it drop. There it is. Great. Now, if I want a continuous integration and deployment, I need to enable it. So click here. That's great. So now I'm ready to add the steps. We need to click here, one job, zero task. We'll click on there. And to be able to release, we'll need three tasks. So the first one, we'll go here. It is to deploy the ARM template. So if we search for resource manager, here we have the Azure resource group deployment. That's what we want, so we add that one. And next, if you notice, when I was creating the ARM template, I didn't have any place to specify that I want the static website enabled. So to do that, I will need to use or execute Azure CLI command. So we'll need a step for that. So if I search CLI, I see this, so we'll add that. And finally, the last step, of course, will be to copy the file into Azure. So let's do file. And I have here the Azure file copy. Copy file to a blob or a VM. That's exactly. So now we have the three steps that we need to configure to be able to deploy in Azure. Let's start by the first one. So the Azure deployment. So first, obviously, I will need to identify my subscription. So I'll pick my subscription and authorize it. I'll just move it up. So when it's done, I need to create or update a resource group. I will just call that one WEM demo. Location, I will use East2S. And now the artifact, if I just scroll down again. So now the artifact is the linked artifact because our artifact are published. So I want to grab my ARM template. So I'll go here and now in drop, I will have another folder drop and then deployment. And I will have here my deploy.json file. So I'll pick this. And that's why here I could be using a parameter file to have multiple parameters or just have an override of a parameter using a local variable. That will be very useful. But since it's a demo, I will keep my default value. So that step is done. I will keep everything else by default. So now in Azure CLI, again, I need to specify my subscription. And I won't use a script path because the command is very short. I will do an inline. So I will script inline. And the command is so az storage blob, because I'm talking to the blob storage, and then service property update, because that specification of the static website, it's in the service properties. So I'm going there, and then I obviously identify my account name, so Winamp Frank Demo, and then I specify that the static website and the index document will be indexed. Great. So that's done. The only thing missing now is copying the file. So copying the file, I need to identify my source. So of course for us, it's in the drop folder and it will be the output subfolder. Voila. And as a destination, I will need to identify again my subscription. So destination for us is a blob storage. It's not a VM. So let's pick blob storage. And now the storage account will use it. That's why it's convenient when you're using variables, because this way you don't do any typo. So now I need to specify the container, and for me right now I have no choice, it's $web. Why $web? Because that's the value used by Azure to specify a static website. So you use this and that's it. Now all the file content in the output folder will be copied to web. Now I just need to save it and do a release. So the website is generated. That's perfect. You know now how to create from A to Z an Azure pipeline to generate a static website using Cake and deploying it in Azure Storage. If you have other ideas, leave it in the comment section or join me from the YouTube channel and click on the tab Community. I'm waiting for your ideas. Thank you for watching. See you next time.